Good day, I'm Samantha Allen and this is your GIS News for Thursday, May 9. About 37,000 persons have benefited from the Jamaica Emergency Employment Program, JEEP. Under the program, which was launched in 2012, some 950 projects were executed in parishes all across the island. In making his sectoral presentation in Parliament on Tuesday, Transport, Works and Housing Minister Dr. Omar Davies said the housing component of the JEEP would be expanded. Food for the Poor will construct 600 concrete units, each 360 square feet, and sell them to the National Housing Trust for $9,500 each.
What we need to do is to get bands of young workers, construction workers, throughout the country who can replicate this. Because, Mr. Speaker, this unit allows us to provide for persons who were outside of the demand, persons making between 5,000 and 7,500.
In the meantime, the construction of houses for indigent families will continue. So far, 383 wooden units have been constructed for persons who lost their houses during Hurricane Sandy. Government is moving to establish the Land Transportation Authority by the next fiscal year to improve efficiency for the traveling public. A consultant is to be hired to oversee the formation of the new entity, which will result from a merger of the Transport Authority and the Island Traffic Authority. Transport Minister Dr. Omar Davies says the aim is to merge the various systems governing the transportation sector to make them work better.
Very few of the systems collaborate, and one of the things we are working on is to try to link all the systems.
In the meantime, the Transport Minister is optimistic that the new Road Traffic Act will be passed this parliamentary year. Sugar production has increased significantly at some divested sugar estates, while government works to support others that have experienced decline. Sugar production at Everglades has increased by almost 70%, moving from 3,984 tons last year to 6,674 tons this year. Agriculture Minister Roger Clark told Parliament on Wednesday that the entity is on track to record a further 56% increase in sugar production for the 2013-2014 crop year. Golden Grove, on the other hand, is poised to record a 14.5% increase in sugar production. Minister Clark said government meanwhile was committed to working with Pan Caribbean Limited to get their sugar production back on track.
If Pan Caribbean takes the necessary corrective action, then we could see their production increase in the 2015-16 crop year.
Sugar production at Pan Caribbean Limited has been down by 23% in comparison with 2010-2011, when the entity was under government control. Pan Caribbean Limited comprises the Froome, Monymusk and Bernard Lodge estates. Sugar production for this year is projected at 125,000 tons. The Education Ministry will be tackling challenges associated with the underachievement of boys through its Advancing the Education of Boys project. The three-year project, which was launched recently, seeks to develop strategies that will create an enabling educational environment for boys. Education Minister Ronald Thwaites says three new diagnostic centers will be available to schools later this year, which will allow for early diagnosis and increase the chance for improved performance among boys.
We believe that many students, we know from the statistics, have real cognitive and social difficulties that, unless they are diagnosed and treated, will cause cramps and curtailment throughout the educational process.
The Advancing the Education of Boys project is a joint undertaking with the Jamaica Teaching Council, with funding and technical expertise from the Commonwealth Secretariat. Jamaica is one of four Caribbean countries involved in the project, and 13 schools from 7 parishes have been selected to participate. And that's it for GIS News today. I'm Samantha Allen. Thanks for watching.